I was in eighth grade when she passed, and I felt like the world just collapsed on me when she died. At that point, that's when I realized I wanted to play at the next level, and I wanted to take this as far as I can.
Yeah, yeah. Parked at the days in, it taking no days in. Yeah, don't need a vacation, I need a replacement.
Basketball to me means everything. It's the only thing I've ever done. It's probably the only thing I'll ever do. And for me, my goal is to make it my job one day. My mindset before every game is I come into the game and I just want to kill. I want to go out there, play my best, get my teammates involved, and have fun. The passing of my grandma impacted me off the court. It was probably the worst thing that's ever happened to me, because to me she was everything. She was my mom, my dad, the person who took care of me, and she was the most beautiful woman in the world. I was in eighth grade when she passed, and I felt like the world just collapsed on me when she died. So now, everything that I do is for her. When I realized I wanted to pursue basketball was probably in the fifth grade. I wasn't always the best player on my team. When I first started playing in fourth grade, I was honestly the worst player on the team. But going into my sixth grade year, I wanted to get better and I wanted to be the best player on the team. So I worked over that summer and ended up being the best player on the team. At that point, that's when I realized I wanted to play at the next level and I wanted to take this as far as I can.
So I can't never chill with them, cause bird by flop. I got a rifle, I put a scope on that bitch, watch they get popped. Drop. No, I'm not scared, yes, I will stand on you. Live on the beach, I'm tired of this sand issue. Watch out my niggas, they come and dismantle you. I got a farm, my whip is all manual. I could pull up in some big bullshit phantom too. Diamonds my canines, that's 150 grand or two. These niggas, I swear these boys, they be fans of me. So how the fuck it, I don't be a fan of you. I'm so high, but a nigga not landing, dude. This is a Daytona charge. Diamond my neck, I live flawless.
I'm very proud of you guys for fighting through adversity, getting tougher as the game went on, finishing when we needed to, making plays when we needed to, all right, hitting shots when we needed to, we'll right back at it tomorrow. There's absolutely no excuses.
Fresh out the fridge, my brody top shot, whip in the kitchen, compass the start, ain't no ignition, raised up the bar, don't do the limit.
My thoughts about playing at the next level, it's definitely a blessing. Because not many people get this opportunity. So it's something I always keep in the back of my mind. Some people I would like to thank is definitely my assistant coach, Juju. He's been a father figure for me. He's been someone I could go to about anything and everything. Some other people would be like my mom for always having my back with everything. My brother for always pushing me. And all the coaches for coaching me and teaching me.
Done saying, I'm done playing. Last time is on the outro. Stuck in the house, need to get out more. I've been stacking up like I'm fundraising. Most people in my position get complacent. Wanna come places with star girls and they end up on them front pages. I'm quiet with it, I just ride with it. Moment I stop having fun with it, I'll be done with it. I'm the only one that's putting shots up like a potluck. You need to come with it, don't run from it. Like H sound in the summertime, I keep it 100. Met a lot of girls in my times there and were the Paul Wall, not one fronted. I was birthed there in my first year, man. I know that place like I come from it. Back
there and there's no one there. These days I could probably pack it for like 20 nights if I go in there. Back rub for my